Welcome to Cinerapolis, Forskin, Minnesota, in the rowdy, bloodstained Thunderdome. The fans have already moved on from drinking beer in cheap plastic cups to drinking ale and freshly harvested skulls. I, for one, am glad the broadcaster's booth is an old World War III bunker. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers and lots of beers. The new Yuck Tyrants go up against the Purple Mutant Eaters. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hogan, everybody. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
That's me.
And his mutant hobbit head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
How about you shut the fuck up?
Well played, Jr. Moving on. Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He takes a licking and keeps on ticking. And it's first and ten. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of seven on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and ten. And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to fight it.
And it's first and ten. Shithouse. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and ten. You've got to love a player who goes down fighting. Second down and two. One speed. Second down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. With a punishing hit. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. That would have been a disappointing run. It's even a worse throw. Well, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. And he snags the punt and looks for open. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with the no mustard?
Yo, man, nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and 10. First down. And the running game opens up for them. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And it's first and 10. And that's a pick. And now the crow, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
He didn't. You know what? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
And it's first and 10. In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, the player on roid rage would win. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Five on that play. Second down and 5. It's first and 10. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Brix's mom decided to move.
The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Hey, who don't do that?
First down and 5. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Yay.
Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. It's first and 10. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. Second down in a very lot. Gets another pick. Man, rough day. He refuses to go down. Oh, he just got crushed.
There's a bloody red head on the field.
No, that's their red penalty marker, Briggs. Looks like this one's coming back. First and 10. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me.
You know, letting these dogs into the league is a slippery slope, Grim. First them, then vampires, then mermaids, then before you know it, we're letting in cat girls. You know, things really start to get weird at that point.
And they line up for the extra point. It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yowling.
And it's first and 10.
You ever get hit in the head with a bulldog, Grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was what?
Quarter one comes to an end. If they don't get it together, this game is going to turn into a rout. And that'll be second and 8 to go. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Third and 4. whose eyes he's using, but can we get him some new ones? Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Yeah, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And it's first and ten. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Well.
Second down and a lot. That run is good for 9 yards. Third down and three. For a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and ten. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
It was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants.
And the defense just called him, and he just wrestles away from that tackle. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. He's at the 20. Oh, monster hit. Scratch him off the roster. He's a goner. And it's first and 10. Dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
For a 4-yard gain. Second down and six. I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep.
Seriously.
Third grade. Go talk. Sister Mary Margaret of our ladies of holy hell.
World.
I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And it's first and ten. Oh, what a sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. Third down and, well, good luck. Picking up chunks of yards now. Nice reception for 10 yards. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot. Oh, man, talk about running into a buzzsaw, Bricks.
Okay, he just ran into a buzzsaw. One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light.
Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and ten.
It's a zap attack!
Devastating hit knocks the ball loose. And then hit jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. First in and three. Saved a touchdown on that deflection. Second and three. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
It's first and ten. He is fighting for every yard. Has him catch for three. Receiver needs to break some tackles. Second down and seven. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
You stupid jerks. You guys suck.
And it's first and ten. Well, he made the pass, but then a slap in the face by the defense.
Aw, that's me in the hotel bar every night.
Hey.
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. Second down and ten. They've used a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Those guys don't know which way forward is now. And he's running. Nicely done. Picks up three on that pass play.
Ooh la la.
Well, that's two timeouts burned. And you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Grim. But it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. The 20. He's at the 10. And he picks up the loose ball and rumbles into the end zone for the score. Nice going. The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
And like if they rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just
good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah.
Oh, nice hit. And it's first and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. It's a tie game at the end of quarter 2. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, during the half, can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
The teams come out of halftime all tied up and ready to battle it out.
Oh, geez, Grim, I hope someone ties them soon. They gotta play football.
I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10.
It looks like the defense handed out shrinking pills.
That's it. And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division and weep tonight. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my offseason.
And it's first and 10. A mix of tiger blood, shark blood, and internet comments. Roid Rage brings it into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races.
Baby, I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see it.
And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. And that mutant just about met his maker on that hit.
I thought he was made in China.
I don't see any Chinese guys down there.
You're a fucking moron.
And it's first and 10. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Oh, the old Brokeback Mountain play. Got hit by a mountain of mutant. The coach isn't liking that call. exploded. First down in less than a yard. The defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and 10. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. And it's first and 10. Maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and 7. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7.
This isn't funny. I swear to drunk, I'm not God, but...
And that's another pick. Man, oh, man, the defense is going to have more receptions than the offense.
You ever have a bottle of hot sauce shoved up your ass?
Quite the description of that painful hit, Junior.
Huh? No, it's a question here on this online dating profile. It doesn't say if on purpose or by accident. Yeah, I'll leave a blank.
For Mutant Tartar. He's at the 40. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, I'm going in circles.
It's 1st and 10. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
2nd down and 10. Agent, well, that's a real buzzkill. And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit, Grim.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, with the brutal hit. And it's 1st and 10. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, man, Brooks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim.
The 10.
Touchdown!
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
And Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They just be
straight through the uprights. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
The defense lost another linebacker on that play, and only 2 remain on the roster. Their defense is getting very close to forfeiting this game. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's 1st and 10. Second down in a very lot. That's a catch for a 10-yard gain. Third and 4. Keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
The offense lost their final running back. Lucky for them, they're on defense now.
Yeah, lucky to have survived so much bad luck, carnage, and death, Grim.
And it's 1st and 10. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's 1st and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have to made it to Dice Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And it's 1st and 10. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's 1st and 10. Caught for the 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. Gets the ball, gets today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. And it's first and 10.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and 10. How you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
They weren't even on the same page on that play. Third down and 10. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just get the points and let's move on.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. And it's first and 10. Quarterback goes down. Zoom on his face. I want to see if he's crying. Second down and more than the QB would like. Throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. Third down and 8. Tell our viewers what you would do, Bricks. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and 10. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered. I know how they said never hit a man when he's down. He's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And it's first and 10. Remember, folks, in the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And he's off to the races. And it's first and 10. The lineman swats the ball away with those meaty paws.
What? It looks so snuggly.
Yeah, I guess if you're a monster. Second down and 10. Huh? Rangers after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
First and 10. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. Game and pick up the first.
Oh man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Grim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore.
First down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. Threads the... Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time.
Your time for time. My only week in hours.
And it's first and 10. Brain scrambler. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they had raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10. He is rolling thunder and pouring pain. It's a zap. That ball was almost intercepted. Second down and 10. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And it's first and 10. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. He had it for a second there. Second down and 10. third down and never gonna happen. And that pass play is good for 8 yards. 2 minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back after I top off my drink.
Grab me a scotch while you're up.
And they'll line up for the punt here. Nice punt. Should move him back nice. He's got the ball. Oh, mama. He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry up too?
Rip, can I kill him?
Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the...
They stumped the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
He's got a receiver breaking open. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Oh, man, he hit that line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet of crap. The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
Man, this new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's Matt's Stupsy time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
He's not, and he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Yeah, move, baby. No, you didn't. You know what? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest, I tell you.
And it's perfect. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? Clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
And he snags it for 6. Touchdown! Touchdown! They're going for 2 points. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more. Oh, devastating hit! You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
The kicker's gonna have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. That, ladies and mutants, is how you recover an onside kick. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. For all. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
The offense is down to their last two receivers. Once they're gone, it's game over, baby.
Those poor receivers, they're really getting a snot kicked out of them. Someone ought to just shoot them, put them out of their misery.
Don't worry, that's coming. And it's 1st and 10. points on the heels of an epic run.
Don't call things epic, Rip. Kids aren't gonna think you're cool no matter what you do.
Junior, I don't want kids to think I'm cool. Well, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. His way out of that tackle. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go with the vicious kill.
Did you know?
The Purple Mutant Eaters are nothing but blue today, taking a home loss.
Does that mean they'll eat a different color? Am I sent to ask them for autographs, Grim? What color eats what, Grim?
And let's go down to the field and hear the MVP. He's a real role model for the kids, Bricks. That is, if you want your kids to be a roid-raging narcissist with uncontrollable verbal diarrhea.
Oh, that personality sort of has a name. It's called autotrophism.
Yeah, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? Well, you mistake, man. You get up my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. I'm gonna wreck it.
Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you...